Hey friends, my name is Jace Thomas, and I serve as the student pastor at Prince Avenue Baptist Church. And basically what that means is every week I spend a significant amount of time around hundreds of middle school and high school students. So I have a really fun job, but what I want to do is just take a few minutes and encourage you and share some tips with you on maybe how to connect with youth, especially if you've never done this before. It can be an intimidating job, it can be a difficult job, but it is a rewarding job. And I just want to say, first of all, thank you for doing it. Thank you for spending time with these teenagers and with these youth and helping them with their projects and mentoring them. This is just not about solely about building character. It's not just about accomplishing the project or learning life skills. What you're doing is helping them learn about who they are. You're helping them build their identity. And so this is really important what you're doing. So thank you. So what I want to do now is just share a few tips with you that might help you in your mentor relationship with these youth. The first thing I'd say is this. There is this common misconception that in order to do well with youth, to lead well with youth, to mentor them, you have to have an inherent personality type. You may think, oh, well, I can't work with teenagers, or I'm not going to do super well with them because I don't have a ton of energy, or because I'm not super goofy and funny. Or maybe you even think things like, you know what, I'm not caught up on the culture. I don't know the music they listen to. I don't know the movies or the celebrities or the TV shows that they watch. I don't know any of that stuff. And let me just tell you, you don't have to have any of that kind of stuff or any of that kind of knowledge or any inherent personality to connect well with youth. Like, so let's just throw all that stuff out. Here's what I want you to know. There are certain things students are asking themselves any given time you're spending time around them. Whether they realize it or not, they're asking themselves two questions. One, they're saying, who am I? They're trying to figure out who they are. And then two, they're saying, who likes me? And so if you just look at every interaction with your student and the youth that you meet with and you mentor as an opportunity to answer those questions. So how do I show this student who they are? How do I affirm their identity? And then how do I show them that I care about them? I like them. I enjoy being around them. If you do those two things, it's going to make your mentor relationship go so much easier, so much smoother, and it's going to encourage the student that you're mentoring. That's the first thing I'd tell you. It's not about an inherent personality. It's about helping them understand who they are and who likes them, and you can do that for them. The second thing I'd tell you is if you want to connect with them really well, you can do two things. One, care for them. Care for them. Ask them how their day was. Don't just make it all about the project or the task at hand. Get to know the student that you're mentoring. Ask them about life. Ask them about the things that are going really well. Ask them about the things that are really difficult right now. And keep up with them as you meet with them. Ask them about things maybe you've talked about previously and check in with them. So care for them. The other thing I'd tell you is be consistent in how you care for them. So if they know week to week that they can trust you and they can rely on you, that goes a long way in the mind of a teenager. If they know that you care for them and you're consistent in their life, then you're going to connect with them way faster and way easier. We don't know the background of every student. I work with a lot of teenagers that come from a lot of different home lives, a lot of different families, some broken families. And for you to be an adult in their life that cares for them consistently, you might be the only person in their life that's doing that for them. So you're playing an important role in their life. So if you want to connect with them, remember, care for them consistently. And then the last thing I would tell you is don't treat them like a kid. Now, they're going to act like kids sometimes, and you need to hold them accountable. But for the most part, students are going to connect with you way faster if you just treat them like an adult. If you expect that from them, they usually rise to the challenge. And not only that, it can be really hard sometimes. Let me just encourage you with this. I have trouble sometimes, and I connect with students pretty easily, I feel like. But there are times where if I'm meeting one-on-one with a student and I'm mentoring them, that it feels like we just didn't connect. Things didn't go well. It was kind of awkward. Let me just tell you, that is super normal. But if you continue to care for them consistently, you treat them like an adult, you make sure that they know that you like them, like you spend that time with them, investing in them, it's going to start to happen. And so just know this, it takes time. It takes time. But if you're consistent and care for them, man, you're going to have a great friendship, a great relationship, leading and pouring into these teenagers. So thank you for what you do. I hope this was helpful at some level, but I'm excited for everything that these students have in store because you're going to take the time to pour into them and lead them and help them with their project. So thank you. Hope you guys have a great day and good luck mentoring these teenagers.